Strachan still preparing to take the free kick. Chapman hasn't gone far post. Berardi's on the penalty spot, speeds in there. Chapman is now going in. Finds him near post instead. Strachan. And the whistle's gone. It's all over. And the fans predictably invading the pitch. They really didn't ought to be there. But they are anyway. And let's hope this is all good humour. It's not approved. So there we are, the culmination of a marvellous season for Leeds United. Just one game to go, and that's at Bournemouth. But this match has been won in the hardest possible way, because after dominating the game for so long, it must really have been a hammer blow when McAllister equalised on 62 minutes after Sterland had shot Leeds ahead in the first half. As it was the captain courageous, the man who's inspired Leeds all season. It was fitting that he was the man who should get the goal. He stuck it home with his left foot, and as it turned out, it was the winner. Gordon Strachan has had a terrific season here for Leeds. The crowd today, 32,597. As I say, they're out there on the pitch enjoying themselves. They really shouldn't be there. But nevertheless, the final score, Leeds United 2, Leicester City 1. These are very emotional moments for the supporters, of course, especially those who followed Leeds for a long period of time. 1964 was the last occasion that promotion was achieved, 26 years ago, and indeed it's 8 years ago since the team slipped out of the First Division. They're not quite back there yet, but they're very near. Very near indeed. Moment they're going absolutely crazy out there on the pitch, and it could well be that they've got some advanced news from St James's Park that we haven't got. As soon as we get it, it could well be that Newcastle, who if they were to draw today or indeed fail to win, would guarantee Leeds promotion. If Leeds won their match, they have indeed won their match, but we still haven't got any news from St James's Park. The crowd were obviously reacting there to suggest that Newcastle had failed to win. Well, as I said earlier, they really shouldn't be on the pitch, but it's all good humour. The amusing thing is that many of them, having got there, are not really sure what to do. They're turning back to the stand, they're displaying their banners. Some of them have their faces painted. I saw a man with a blue and yellow quartered face earlier today. I saw an open top VW Golf driving down with the banners and the flags waving from it. This is their moment and they're enjoying it. Pitch, and there's a giant conga developing now in front of the south stand, all across the penalty area. It's celebration, there's no malice, and I would think it'll make a change actually for the visiting fans, the Leicester fans. Rather than having to be held in their pen on the far side, they can be released early and on their way back to the Midlands. Still the celebrations go on. Well, there's impromptu singing, impromptu dancing. Arms being thrown in the air. It's a wonder they haven't shouted themselves hoarse already for almost the opening 20 minutes of the match. They never stopped cheering. And they still seem to find more energy. I would suspect most of them are staying on the pitch waiting for the result from Newcastle. It hasn't been confirmed yet, but the last we heard, the Magpies were winning 2-1. And along with the victory for Sheffield United, that would leave matters exactly as they were before the game, but of course with one less to play.